All right. Well, welcome everybody. I'm going to do just one more quick mic check just to make sure I've made a couple of adjustments. I'm actually tri-streaming this, so we have it going through GoToWebinar, YouTube, and Facebook. So I had to adjust my mics. So one more mic check and then we'll get started. If you can hear me, once again, if you could please just type it into the question saying, yeah, okay, thanks, John. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate that. All right, let's go ahead and get it, get into this. I'm really excited to be here today with you guys. My name is Ryan Olson. Thank you, Wynn. Thank you. My name is Ryan Olson. A lot of you guys probably already know me. I've been with Nirvana Systems for 13 or 14 years. And I've been in various roles throughout the company throughout that time, you know, from support to some development to marketing to this. I'm the Swiss Army knife. Wherever they need me, I end up going. But throughout all this time, I've had one big passion, and it's been trading. You don't really join a company like Nirvana if you don't have some kind of passion towards what you're doing. So my passion really comes down to the Rhino Suite. And you guys, for those of you who have the original Rhino, you saw the entire progress from, you know, me being excited to Nirvana catching on to it and releasing it, and then all of the education we did behind it, and ultimately it became the best-selling plugin of 2020, and actually it was one of the best-selling plugins of about a five-year stretch, which just was amazing to me because the concepts and the ideas within the original Rhino Suite were, at the time, truly unique. You hadn't really seen anything. You know, there's a lot of plugins out there that kind of take concepts and ideas, you know, from moving averages to, you know, however these other plugins are working, but you know, they kind of base off of the same ideas and reworking it and giving you different formulas. Well, Rhino Suite came into this and it was completely different. Basically, Rhino Suite came in and we built everything off of market structure levels. And if you weren't familiar with the term market structure, it was something that, you know, it could be considered kind of a support and resistance, or it could be, you know, a trend line, but really it's going to be an area on the chart that price is magnetic to, it reacts to time and time again. Now, this concept didn't come to me, you know, out of the blue. Back in 2012, I became friends with a software developer who worked for a financial institution, and we had got there and we were, you know, sitting there and you know, talking about trading and everything. And at the time I was kind of a novice, you know, I had started trading the SPY, the ETF, for the S&P, and had done a little bit of ES trading, a little bit of, you know, natural gas in the futures. And I was sitting there and I was talking about it, and I said, you know, I really have some ideas about this, but it all seems so complicated. And he was telling me, you know, it's not nearly as complicated as we, you know, commercial trade or our the residential traders, or, you know, traders like you and I make it out to be. He said, I can't speak anything about the futures, but I know something about the SPY. And basically his insight to me at that time was that the financial institutions aren't necessarily trading on emotions. They have a lot of people out there that are, you know, actually placing the trades. They have algos that are placing the trades, but the calculations for all of these algos and these moves that they're making happen on the first tick of the day. And I, you know, started talking. I'm like, well, that doesn't really make sense because, you know, at 8 o'clock, you know, there's already trading that's been going on. You know, he corrected me. He goes, the first tick doesn't happen at 8 o'clock. It typically happens about 3 o'clock central. And it doesn't matter what the size of the bar is. It doesn't matter what it does after that, but their algos are using this first price. So at that point, he couldn't go into any more detail about what they were doing. But what it really did is it gave me a spark to get in and start digging in and trying to find out a little bit more about what these institutions are doing. So basically, that's where Rhino First Print came up with. And that was the spark that created the entire original Rhino Suite. And basically what it is I created a calculation based off of the very first tick of data, based off of his, you know, his information. And then I went through thousands of charts and found this calculation that really, really accurately was able to predict market structure levels. Now, I have a chart up right now, and it looks a little bit confusing, and it's confusing because I added extra stuff on there, but it's kind of just to give you an idea of what the original, well, this is actually the harmonic, but it's the same concept. But basically, you have these horizontal lines that would go across, not necessarily this many with the first print, but it would go and it would find these key levels based off of first, you know, the very first tick of data, and it would give you this concept, this idea of if you're trading something, the SPY or Apple or Tesla or any of these, you know, as price was moving up to these levels, it was kind of a now's the time to pay attention, right? And all of the levels, they're pre-calculated, they're static, meaning that they don't update. You know, as if Apple gains $15 or loses $15 in a session, it doesn't matter. These levels were static, which is really helpful if you kind of have these ideas of where you're potentially going to be seeing these, you know, these pullbacks, say like right here in September, or, you know, actually this is a daily chart. The Rhino first print was an intraday, so you would see it on the intraday charts. And we'll get into the first print here in a little bit. But basically it just gave you these really powerful concepts. And then at that point, I kind of just started to build on it. I came up with something called the Rhino summary, which I took, 16 different indicators, some moving averages, some oscillators, and I came up with an indicator that would help predict kind of this flowing sentiment of what's going on in the market. So we added that in, and we had some, you know, other things that were added in, the Rhino HMA or whole HMA, which is, it's a variation of the whole moving average, that I changed some of the calculations, and we, you know, put a nice little treatment on it for color and everything like that. But we built the entire suite kind of based on these concepts and these ideas. Well, you know, I've been here for a very, very long time. So I see, you know, the questions coming in through support, and people are constantly emailing me even today about, you know, the Rhino and different things that they're finding out, and, you know, they're still loving it and this and that. So I have this email box that I just keep all of this stuff in. And here recently, you know, with COVID, it gave me a lot of opportunity to kind of dig in and try to come up with some new ideas or build on the Rhino concept. So here we are. I'm proud to announce the Rhino Suite 2.0. Now, the Rhino Suite 2.0 officially launches tomorrow. We've been having a little bit of a pre-sale right now, kind of sending it out, emails out to people who already owned the original one to kind of give them an idea of what's going on. But during this presentation, over the next 15 or so minutes, we're going to dig in to some of the new concepts, some of the improvements, some of the strategies, different ideas, things that we've come across or that we've come up with through this process. And then, you know, if you like it, there's a special at the end. We start our education. If you guys remember the first one, it was pretty in-depth education. We start that education on Tuesday. And then we have a follow-up one. I believe it's on Wednesday or Thursday. So we're going to dig in. I'm going to go in and really just teach you everything about the new version, because it's exciting. It's not just the market structure. We've actually added some meat behind it to really help you get you these razor sharp reversals, as we said in one of the marketing pieces, or you know, this new concept to work in line with what's there. So in this new one, I've created four new indicators. Now, three of the indicators were ones that I came up with, you know, on my own throughout this process. I'm using a new, I'm calling it a predictive formula, but basically each one of the strategies is using different concepts on price action for, you know, segments of data, different ranges of data to help predict when you're going to get these, you know, sharp reversals, kind of like what you're seeing on the chart. Now, this system does fire longs and shorts, so you can have it, but the package comes with it all as longs. The market has really just kind of been in a long since COVID. So being able to find these small pullbacks, not necessarily getting in you know, at the low of COVID and just riding it out, which there's, if you had the Rhino one, you probably still have some strategies that it's riding out. And that's great if you're a super long-term investor, but a lot of people want to actually engage the market. And that's kind of what my thinking was as I started crafting this new version of Rhino, was something that is still highly profitable, extremely accurate, but actually lets you to get in and not just have all of your, you know, your entire account stuck in something that's running for, you know, going on 2 years. So you're going to see a lot more trades in this. You're going to see these reversals that are based off of a couple of different things. It's going to be a culmination of three different indicators working together to really give you these prime examples, or these prime reversals, rather. So we're let's go ahead and jump into this and take a look at it. So as I said, Rhino Bands is building off the original concepts that I had come up with, but we've added the new ability for it to use the Rhino Bands, which is one of the new systems, to find these key reversals. Now, the Rhino Bands strategy itself is the utilizing all of these concepts at one time. The Rhino Synapse, which is the second strategy we'll talk about on the next slide, it uses a little bit different kind of concept, and we'll go over that here briefly. But basically, the Rhino Bands is down here at the bottom of the screen, and it's using basically it's using a segment of time, and then adding a predictive formula based on whatever segment of time you've selected. By default, I have it set for 20 bars, but it takes that segment of data and then it will predict out a couple of bars. Now, with that prediction, it needs a couple of other things. First, you'll see that we have something in here called the Rhino Summary 2, which we're going to get into in just a minute, but it's utilizing the new Rhino Summary 2 on a bullish or bearish spectrum and then confirming it with the key levels from either the Rhino Harmonic in end of day or the first print on your intraday. So it's really going through and identifying these areas, confirming these areas, and then giving you these just really super explosive moves. So this is an example. Again, you have a lot of things on here, obviously. You know, by default, the chart template that you're getting isn't going to have the harmonic. This was more of a demonstration to kind of show you everything what's going on. But this is the end of day chart template, which you're seeing right here, and some of the signals that it had at the bottom. The second strategy is the Rhino Synapse, and this is going to be using the other predictive formula that we have. Now, this one is using six separate, distinct market activity kind of concepts to come up with one good area where it really pinpoints these reversals. Now, it's different. You'll see that, you know, this one typically will last a little bit longer, but it's really just picking out the exact perfect time. Now, I added the Synapse system down at the bottom. This isn't part of the chart template, but I wanted, since I have the strategy set up going to you guys as long only, I kind of wanted to give you an idea of how it works across the board. So just kind of starting over here, you can see that as the system starts to fire, you're getting these fantastic bullish runs, and then, oops, I went too far. Let me go back here. And then, you know, you'll see where the exits are, or if you set it up for shorts, which we're going to go over all of this in the training. Actually, the training is going to be really, really in depth. I'm going to go through and we're going to create some additional strategies for different types of trading. But really, I just wanted to kind of show you on this slide, you know, the key areas that it's using to find those reversals on both directions. So I hope this kind of conveys that. Once again, that system isn't normally plotted there, but it's just incredible on finding these reversals. And again, it's utilizing some of that same predictive technology that's in the Rhino Bands, but this one is using six different variations of this market action concept that I've come up with. So I'm pretty excited about it, and I've got a lot of emails from you guys since then. But let's go ahead and talk about, you kind of have an idea of two of the systems that are coming up, but we've also improved some of the things that were in Rhino 1. So like I said, I've had emails from you guys coming just steadily for a year now, over a year, from when the Rhino 1 came out. And I take your guys' feedback really, really seriously. There was feedback from the education on ways to improve it, some things that you guys found out afterwards. And then in this particular case, this one, this concept came from one of you guys. So in Rhino Suite 2.0, we've created a new Rhino first print. So the way that the first print worked in the original one, which is this image here on the back, basically I had a multiplier. And the multiplier was based off of the SPY ETF. Obviously, I told you guys at the beginning that that's what I traded personally. So it was kind of formulated around that. And it was great on the SPY. It was great on everything, except for you had to go in and change this multiplier and kind of fit to the other stocks, which, you know, you can fit anything to a stock. You want something that is actually predictive more than you form fitting. And unfortunately, in that original first print, you could get to the point where you're form fitting. Now, the one thing about this is once you find a range on a stock, say here on Apple, it's using the 42 cent calculation. Once you find what's there, you'll find that it works the entire way through. So it's not that you're curve fitting to the current bar. You're going to see that, but it's a lot of work to go through. And another problem with that first one is, so what if you trade more than Apple? What if you go over to Nvidia? Or maybe you're on, you know, you go from Apple, which is 150, to American Airlines, which is, what, 40 or something like that. Now you're having to go and change it on each one of them. Well, one of our customers sent me an email sometime in the last year. I don't remember exactly when he sent it, but I was looking at it over the last couple of weeks. And he had this concept of how we could change the calculation. And he showed me some information that he had. So we took that information, we modified it, because it didn't work across the board, but the concept was just really, really amazing. So we updated the Rhino to the new Rhino first print, which you no longer have to do anything to. It goes through, again, it's off of the first tick of data. In this particular case, this is just a 5-minute chart, so it's not including the intraday, but for the example, it was a little bit cleaner than showing a lot of sporadic bars. But it takes that first tick of data and it projects all of your market structure levels for the entire day. So basically we opened here, you had a market structure level here, here, and here. They're all established right off the bat. So it's not, again, it's not creating or modifying or changing throughout the session. These are just going to be exactly the market structure levels. And as you can see, as price came up, it dropped right down to your market structure level. Now, market structure is not an exact level. You're not looking at something coming and going, blip, right here. Oh, look, it was exactly right. That's not what it does. It's showing you areas on the chart that through time are a level that the stock will react to time and time and time again. So it's not saying this is going to be resistance. This is where two ticks or two bars come up and touch exactly, and that's where we say it's resistance. That's not what market structure is. But you have this area that this range that the price reacts to, and then you get a nice push up. You can see that it comes back up to this market structure level. It reacts, both pulling back and then back through, and then it closes at the top of that market structure. And then the next day, it comes out with a new set of market structure, and it, you know, off of the first tick, it comes up, it identifies these levels that are going to be there, and then it plots it out. And then it will just do that pretty consistently throughout. And you can see how price just reacts over and over and over to those levels there. So that's one of the big changes. Both of them are included. So if you get the Rhino Suite 2, you still have the original one. The original one is still really good, and it gives you a lot of micro. I'm calling them micro now. Originally, that's all they were, but micro. So you can get it, as you can see over here on Apple, it's the same chart, but you're getting some micro levels throughout. So you're getting more of the smaller moves. But with this new calculation, you're getting the true market structure levels over and over and over again. And again, you no longer have to do anything like on the original one. These ones are automatic and on every chart. So it's just available from now on. The next big thing that we changed, actually, there's two big improvements from the original. This is the second one, and it's the Rhino summary. As I said when we started, Rhino summary became one of the biggest parts of Rhino Suite 1. And again, basically what it did is it took 16 different moving averages and oscillators, some momentum indicators, and I came up with a formula where it just keeps track of it and kind of gave you just an overall sentiment. That was actually the first name of it. It was called Rhino Sentiment, but it would give you a sentiment of when things were changing. Now, the first early draft, for my uses, this was just perfect. You know, I didn't need much more than this. I used it in my own trading, and it was great. But once it got out into the population, you guys had so many different ideas that I had never come up with. Like, well, I want to use this in Omni language, you know, but I can't determine what's bullish and what's bearish. You just get a single number on it. So we took all of these comments and suggestions that you guys had, and we put it into the Rhino Summary 2. Now, the Rhino Summary 2 over here on the side is a double histogram. So now you have, first, we changed the calculations. We made it really, really Rhino intensive versus just indicator intensive. So we're using a lot more of the indicators from within Rhino. But now we have 19 different variations. And now it's going to give you this really nice sentiment slash heat indicator. So as you can see here, you're getting a good indication of where the heaviness is with the overall market sentiment based on all of the indicators. Plus, you also have where the bullish side of those indicators are. Now, why this is important? This is important because you're going to have zones where you're heavily, heavily red or heavily, heavily green, but you're starting to see that you're getting this transition of bullish indicators starting to come in, which is a really clear indication many times that you're going to be getting that shift, right? You're starting to get overwhelming these smaller time frame indicators. So on the moving averages, let's say you used a 5, a 10, a 15, a 100, a 200. Well, those 5, those 15, and the 10s, those are going to be earlier indicators showing that something is changing. So then, you know, you start getting a culmination of all of these indicators starting to move, and you get something what's happening right here where you still are overwhelmingly bearish. You know, those longer term indicators, it takes a long time for them to start shifting, but you're seeing that increase. And then you can see that gradual transition. And you can also start to see, you know, where it's super bullish, where there isn't any bearishness in it. This example doesn't really have that, but you'll have it where it's just straight up across the top, and there isn't any red, which is just a lot of confirmation that, you know, the trade that you're in is really, really great. Or if you're looking to get into a trade, you have a lot of confirmation. Now, this is an important part of the Rhino Suite too, because it is a filter that's used in signal generation. It's you can use it in your strategies. It's really, really powerful. So this one also, well, we'll just leave it at that. But this one is, I am so excited about it. And it came down to the very end. We didn't really have the technology to do this double histogram like this. So I was working with Gianluca, our developer, and I mean, this, it was on the fence, and he made some really big strides and made this possible, which really just makes this indicator just mind-boggling good. And I've been really, really excited to use this. So, yeah, I'm really excited. All right, so that is the Rhino Summary 2. Now, we didn't just do those indicators. There's a lot of things that you guys had asked for in the past. I'm not sure how many of you are familiar, but we do a live trading show every morning in Discord from 7:07 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. And in this real-time trading, I've come up with some different indicators. We have one that I use in that room called the Rhino Relative Volume. Now, this isn't anything proprietary. It's intraday relative volume. But we've taken that and added in not only the indicator for you guys, because we have real-time strategies that can really take advantage of relative momentum information, but we also added in some additional color charts based on volume movement. Those are all going to be part of this as well. And then, as I said a little bit ago, we have a lot of people who are into to creating their own indicators, their own systems, coding and adding things that we've put in from different plugins. Well, we've gone in and we've made it to where all of the values within Rhino Suite 2, you now have wrappers for. So you're able to use it in any aspect, whether it's Omni scans, Omni language, your indicators, your strategies, your filters. You can use it across the board in any one of them. So you have a ton of control. If you want to take and build and improve off of what's there, that's great. If you have something that you're using, you know, in one of the other products, you can add this in as additional confirmation. And it's a really, really big deal. And it was a big priority to get that on there. So not only that, we talked about this too, but a complete master's trading course. You guys know the first one was 2 live webinars and 2 recorded seminars. Right now, as it stands, this one's going to be 2 live seminars starting on Tuesday, which is going to be with me. It's going to be a midday start. They'll all be recorded and edited and made all nice and made available for you on your dashboard. And then the second one will come right after that. And we're going to be talking in depth about the end of day versions and the real time versions. As I said, there's so many things that I figured out while we were doing this, building different strategies, different concepts behind the strategies. And I didn't want to give you guys like 30 strategies to put in here. So we got it to a form that performs extraordinarily well. But then I have a couple of things that you guys are going to get access to inside the training, including scalp versions of the strategies, shorter term trading versions of the strategies, some midterm. Excuse me. So we're going to go through and we're going to build these live for you guys to where you have those as well. And then we're just going to go into detail on every aspect of this so that you guys are able to hit the ground running right when you're ready to do so. And again, the courses are going to be starting here on the 24th. So then it comes down to the special. So of course, you're going to get the plugin. You're getting all of the new indicators. You're getting the updated information. You're getting new Omni scans. You have multiple chart templates. Again, you're getting the Rhino Master Trading course. So you're getting a pretty extensive package. Now, as I said when we started off, we're in a pre-sale or pre-order special pricing period that is going to be ending end of business tomorrow. The product is going to be ready for download tomorrow afternoon. We tried to get it out on Friday, but I wanted to get that Rhino relative volume in, so it pushed it back just slightly. So the special pricing is ending on tomorrow, end of business. But since you guys took the time out on your Sunday to come hang out with me and listen to me talk about my baby, we are offering 25% off discount. Now, this unfortunately doesn't combine with Nirvana Club. It's Nirvana Club or the 25% discount. So depending on your situation, pick the one which is appropriate to get you the best price on that. It is one or the other. Unfortunately, our new order system doesn't give us the ability to add multiple discounts to something. But either way you go, it's a huge discount for you and a big opportunity. So that is what I have. I'm opening this up to any questions you have. We can jump back, look at any of the slides or talk about anything that you guys have. But this is kind of as I said, I'm super excited about it. I don't know if you guys could hear it in my voice. I've been like sitting here really like trying to get everything super good for the webinar. I've been nervous to put it out there for you guys. So I'm just excited. But that is what I have. So if you guys have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. Also, if you are part of our Discord group, feel free to message me in that. We can talk about that as well. But the actual product will go live tomorrow afternoon. That's when it actually goes on sale for the first time. So if it is something that you're interested in, make sure that you take advantage of the special pricing before then. Yeah, I'm going to put that URL in there. I was going to do that for you. Thank you. I'll do that right now, actually. All right, give me just a second. I see a lot of questions coming in. Let me get this price up there, or not the price, the window here. I'm going to put this through on both. Oops, I sent that privately. I'm going to send this out to everybody. There we go. And get that over to our folks on YouTube and Facebook as well. Can you, let's see, please repeat slowly and clearly about the Nirvana Club versus something like 25% discount. Yeah, Mark. We have, since you guys join, this is really kind of going to be for Nirvana Club members versus non-club members. But the special price that we have is 25% off for today, since you guys came. This discount applies until tomorrow, but it is one or the other. It can't be the club discount and the 25% discount just because of our ordering system. It doesn't allow us to have two discounts applied to any product now. So your club discount is 50% off, and the webinar special is 25% off. So it's a great deal on both sides, but not doubled up. Hey, Bogdan, good to see you, man. Bogdan was our very first Rhino 1 owner. He bought it before it was even available. A fantastic gentleman. And actually, you're going to see something amazing here. I have this up. You want the Rhino summary on the SPY? Yeah, I'll the Rhino summary. Let me get the SPY up here real quick. So, can you see that okay? So the Rhino summary, it's showing, you know, some over the daily, it shows that the majority of it has been in a nice bullish run, but you're starting to see the bearishness start to come in, which is also kind of an indication. You see it on the screen. Now, the big thing is, not only do you have the Rhino summary too. I'm going to plot the original one up here so you can see it as well. Rhino summary one, so you can kind of see the differences in what you would get. So in the original Rhino summary, let me get this one same size here. In the original Rhino summary, you're still kind of, it's still showing bullishness. So it's still showing that overall you're still good, but the new one is actually giving you, showing you that you're actually starting to get a lot of the bearishness in. Something else that's been added is on each one of the bars. It's kind of hard to see on this screen right now, but you now have both values. So you're going to have the bullish value and the bearish value for each one of the bars. So like I said, there's 19. On this bar here, you have 14 bulls and one bear. So you have kind of an in-between. It's not completely bullish. It's not completely bearish, but you have a good ratio there. On that. So that is the Rhino summary 2 on the SPY. Mark, what types of results should I expect for end of day in real time? So as it stands, I can pull this up, and we're going to go through a couple of different things. So on the out of the box, it's getting about 9% profit per trade with about a 60% hit rate. Now, you have to take into consideration that this form here is taking every trade across the board on all stocks, but you're getting about 9% on the Rhino Synapse. And actually, I just made a modification on this one before. Let me change this back real quick. This is something that I was going to show, but I decided not to do it in this presentation. But you can go in and add in the filter back in, which is the way that you're going to get it. And as soon as that's done, we'll look at that. But you're getting about 9% on end of day with the standard out of the box. And then with some of the modifications, you get a lot more trades. It does drop on the profit percent, but you're getting trades that you're actually able to get into. So instead of 9, you're getting somewhere between 5 and 7 on both of the strategies on one of the variations that we'll show you. Now, the scalping, it's a little bit harder to do the real time just because of the data. But what I've been seeing is on a day-to-day test over the last week on real time, I've been getting between 3 and 1.9% per day doing the same test where it's just taking every trade. So I'm not doing a whole lot. You know, the equity curves on the end of day going from 2000 to now, I mean, they're really decent. It goes from 100,000 to, I think it was 350,000 or something like that. We're not selling it as a mechanical one, so we're not really pushing the equity curve. But you know, it's, I don't want to put that in there because it's been really easy to trade, you know, this year. So everybody can have a really great equity curve. But over the back test and forward test periods, 67% hit rate is what you're going to get out of the box if you were taking every trade, 9.48% on the Rhino bands, 60% hit rate on the Synapse with about a 9% profit per trade on that. So I hope that helps that. What's the 25? Let's see. Sorry, I should have probably had the math up there. Let me see here. 95 minus 148. So the, whoops, put me on the spot here. So it's going to be 447 with the 25% off. Right around there, minus some change. I just did the 595 minus 25%. So it's going to be right around that. How do these indicators react to different market conditions? Fantastic. I mean, it's kind of a loaded question because I have been using them. In fact, for those of you who have been part of our Discord channel, this one down here at the bottom, minus the bands, I've had the bands hidden because I've been using the color chart, which is the Rhino bands. Basically, the calculation as the your trigger is crossing over the zero, that's kind of this, it's the trigger for your signal. So you start with that, that's when it turns blue. It confirms with the Rhino summary, and that's kind of what gives you this color change, which is one of the signal generations in the strategy. So basically, anytime it goes from, and again, these aren't pivots. So like if you're a catch a wave user, catch a wave uses, you know, a formula for pivots. This isn't pivots. This is, I mean, I guess technically you could consider that a short-term pivot, but it's not built around pivots. It's built around the reversals. So basically it gives you a color change every time that you're supposed to be buying. So it works. I use it in real time every day on a 1 minute chart. Works fantastic. I use it on a 3 minute chart during the morning show. And then on end of day, it's ridiculously accurate. The other indicators, the Rhino Synapse, I'm not using that one as a display. I'm using it as a signal generator only. I used the word synapse kind of because it's that communication between the cells, you know, that spark that makes everything else communicate. So I don't necessarily look at that system. I brought it up in the slide just so you could kind of see what it's doing. But it's really taking all of those six predictive concepts and putting them into one to give you some really fantastic information. So there's a couple of ways. I keep referring back to the Discord channel because I do a lot of things in there. I'm on there for like 3 or 4 hours a day. But I've done a lot of testing. This is going to be available in Visual Trader here in the next week. So it's not available tomorrow. We have to get a pre-release out for that. But Visual Trader has something called Trade Throttle on there, which is kind of like Omnipilot, where you can go in and trade it. And I've just been putting it on there and letting it go. So it's been on a paper account, but I've been trying to get results and show day after day profitability and things like that. And it's been about 3 weeks since I put it on, but I was averaging between 1900, it's a $100,000 paper account, but I was averaging about $1,900 to about $2,800 a day, auto trading the 1 minute charts, just taking the signals off of the profit, off of the Rhino Synapse, which I'm going to show you how to do in the education, and just letting it go. I mean, it did have losers in there, and there were some losing days in there. So I don't want to say, oh, it's 100%, because it's not. But auto trading it, the majority of the time, it was profitable, and it made me comfortable enough to do it. So, yeah. Yes, Pamela, I was going to get to that, and I forgot. Sorry, the product, or when you go to the checkout, use the product code RHINO. Thank you. You guys would have never gotten it. I apologize. But it is RHINO. Let me send that off to both groups here. Sorry about that. I'm running everything by myself and, oops. Product. Let's see. Product. Code RHINO. So yeah, if you choose to buy it, which I hope you do, product code RHINO gives you the 25% off. Do you discuss options trading? I don't, Mark. I don't do any options personally. So I would not be the person to talk about trading options. I can look into it. I can talk with Jeff and see if he can give me some insight, but I have not done any option trading with it. So if you have a line on the band that goes above or below the band, that indicates a reversal. So it's a little bit more than that, Bogdan, but yeah. So as price is going up, as the trigger line crosses your zero line, which is actually right here, so it's a bar before the reversal. So if you can see on the chart up on the SPY, this is where it's indicating that this is the reversal. And it's happening, you know, intraday bar. So well, this is an end-of-day bar, so you would have got the information afterwards, but it was the end of that run. And then it gives you the signal here that it's time to go. And again, the correlation between the Rhino summary and the Rhino bands is in the actual system. So it is confirming by default, and you can change this, by the way, but by default, I don't have the version. I don't have the live version on it, but you can change the strength. So right now, by default, it requires that the bullish indicator on Rhino Summary has at least 7 in the long column before it will pass that filter to generate a signal. But we'll discuss that and way more in the education. Pamela, don't worry about it. We'll get that taken care of. I appreciate it, but we'll get, you get the discounts. Don't worry about that. We saw the signals before running the to-do list. Now none. Why? So there's a couple of things that go on. So this is this particular one here, but the way that it comes to you right now, out of the box, it does have signals, but it is on a longer term run. That's what I was talking to you about. You're going to have different variations of it where you're going to have some that give you quite a bit, but it has a filter in here in the default strategy that is a reversal check, which is going to be using the trend intensity index. And based on the trend intensity index, it will allow or disallow the signal through. So originally, one of the ways that I'm going to show you how to do it, which had the signals, the reason I did it the way I did it is because the slides that I had on the website was without the reversal signal on it. So it gave you more of the signal. So I wanted to have what you're eventually going to get with the education. But you do still get a lot of them. But with that trend intensity index filter in there, you'll get into trades that last a lot longer. And I kind of wanted to show you that there's a lot of really, really good trades without staying in it as well. So I hope that answers that, Daryl. Can I show a 3-minute spy? I will try to do a 3-minute spy. We'll see if it if I have enough data on there. The web address. This page doesn't give anything. Well, let me get back over here real quick. I actually have the page up, so I can pull it up and copy that URL. So it is right here. Oops, I forgot to copy it. Copy. Paste, sending to all. Try that one out. Hopefully that one works for you. I know it's there. Yeah. So the Rhino Suite, it's not going to be on your dashboard yet. It will be on your dashboard by end of business tomorrow. I don't have the install, so it's not there yet. So don't, if you don't see it, don't worry about it. It will be there, and you'll get an email on it as well. So don't worry about that. So here's the spy. Let's get to a 3-minute. Oops, I don't have 3 minutes on here. I have 3 minutes on my Visual Trader. Hold on just 1 second. We'll get into that. It's going to take it a second to get this pulled up, so we'll look up. Yeah, Bogdan. So yeah, the signals, I wish I could repeat what you're saying, but I agree completely. Thanks, Mark. Sorry about that. I must have gotten too much into the copy and paste or something. So I appreciate you calling that and letting me know. But yeah, Bogdan, the signals are ridiculously good. You know, the signals off the original Rhino were really good as well. They were pretty insane. But again, you would get into a lot of these runners, which is really great if you're a long-term investor. But that was one of the biggest things that people would say is like, the signals are great, but it got in 2 months ago. I don't have an entry right now, and I wanted to fix that. And that's why I want to focus so much on building these out with you, so you know how each one of these processes work with Rhino, so that you can create, if you want, something that is unique and good for you. So here's the Rhino. I forgot why I was coming here. I'm gonna have to look at the. So this is the Rhino predictive and the volume indicator at the bottom. The volume indicator, actually, I use it on 1 minute, typically. But basically, the volume or the Rhino relative volume is taking the last 25 bars of data, and it's looking for the volume today being greater than 2, 5, or 10. You can't really see it on this one because it doesn't get up that high. But you have a yellow bar here. That's 2 times typical volume. This orange line up here is going to be 5 times. And then there's a red line here when it gets up there. You see it a lot on 1 minute charts, but it will be 10 times the volume. And basically, if you're not familiar with the relative volume, this is like a trigger. It's like saying, hey, there's something about to happen. So that's why we included it in there. It doesn't necessarily, you know, work in conjunction with the harmonics or the first print or anything like that. But yeah, it's a really useful tool. And actually, it was one of our people over on Discord who had just bought Rhino 2, and he's like, am I going to get this too? And I was like, oh man, I didn't even think about that. But we were able to get it in, and it's a good bonus for you guys. I mean, we didn't have any kind of relative volume in there right now. So it's really, oops, that's not the one I wanted to get on there. It's a good addition one way or another. I'm glad that it's there for you. Let me see. Rhino. There we go. Rhino Suite and the first print 2. So here's the first print 2. Here's kind of the properties. You don't have the slider anymore. And it just kind of plots it out. Now, one thing you'll notice on this, if I come over here and do the original first print, which is this one right here, you had to adjust it. In fact, you have to actually adjust it to be able to see the changes because it's spot on. Oops, I say spot on, but I didn't actually get it on the right one there. I can't get it, it's behind my window. But yeah, so it's pretty spot on with that. And you know, now this is, you know, a different variation of it, different stock. This is VeriSign, and you can see that with this new calculation, it's almost identical. You have a couple of different levels in here that are slightly different, but for the most part, they are exactly spot on like before. So let's see here. Drop down. This is going to include the, oops, actually, I don't have 1 minute voted on. So we'll let that get on there. But again, it's going to take just a second. Let's see. Can you show XPEV? Yeah, I can pull that up. I want to thank you guys for all of your questions and the fact that all of you have stayed here this entire time. So I really super appreciate that. Also, over on Facebook and YouTube, if you have any questions, we can answer those as well. I'm monitoring those as well. So feel free to ask those. Oops, let me get this over here. Spy. And we'll pull this up. It's going to take a second for it to get in here and get this going. Yeah. So we'll go back. This one had time filters on it, but the Rhino Synapse. So you're going to be finding trades like this where you get that nice move. You have the confirmation across the board as far as the indicators. And, you know, it's right in that consolidation, which gave you another great opportunity. Now, these ones are using different trade plans, a little bit shorter term. Again, in the training, we're going to create scalping ones that have like a 15 cent gain versus loss, so that you're not staying in positions for a really long time. You're getting in and you're able to get small profits and then get out. You do get some misfires every once in a while with, as with anything, you know, it has this, the levels that it's using. So if we get this over here to where it shows the first print, it's using those market structure levels. So as it breaks through, I mean, sometimes you'll get things that are a little bit off, but the majority of them are pretty spot on. Like I said, nothing is perfect. Let me get back to you. XPEV. Yeah, and anybody who tells you that things are always perfect or always gives you the glamorous side of that's part of the reason I wasn't getting them, but anyone who gives you the profitable side only, yeah, there's definitely something amiss with that, you know. So we'll see. That's going to take a second for this to go through and analyze. Sorry about that. I didn't have it on there. Mark, the morning Discord is a subscription, or can we log in to via Discord? Yeah, you can log in. Let me get the Discord invite. You guys are more than welcome. When you get in there, there is a disclaimer room. Just make sure that you click on the disclaimer. Actually, I'll pull it over while it's doing this here. So there's a disclaimer room. You're going to come in here. You have to check the box down here, and that will give you the first set of permission, and then you can message me on there, and I can hook you up with the rest. So this one is a little bit different since we don't have the longs or the shorts in there. You're getting, you know, you have this nice breakout here, which is obviously going to be a nice run. A little bit of a pullback there. That one was a loss of about 0.5%. That one's a break even. Got a little bit of a gain on that one. Well, actually, that was break even too. So this one, with the way that the XPEV has been running, it's catching these little pullbacks. So if that's all you're trading on it, it's going to be a little bit, at least on yesterday, it's been having a hard time on that pullback, unfortunately. So here's the, since the SPI wasn't up originally, you get these ones right here, nice little pullback. And we're going to go through and we're going to build out the strategies that give you all of these really great reversal entries. Again, this in here, it does have some filters in there for reversal checks. And actually both of these ones are reversal checks. So it's trying to overcome when the stock is going down, but it's really looking for these ones that have these really nice runs and then pull back. We can put the first print on there. Hold on. XPEV. So this one, let's get the all sessions going on it. Then we'll go over here to the first print. Get that on there. Let's see here. So here's the first print on that. So you get over here, it creates it. It gives you your first set right here. It did get a nice bump. So right here, it's kind of hard because after the data is already there, you have to get it all on the screen or else it goes away. You have to have it visible. But you have the first reaction here. That's where you have the pullback. Another one comes up to that market structure level here. And that's when you get the pullback. And then again, as you get up to this market structure, I'm surprised that this one, normally it's when it reaches 50% of the move, you'll get the next one. But again, right as it came up to this market structure level, that's where it found support and then fell back through and ended up hanging out right at that. Now, this is only August 20th on this particular one, but you can go back and if the data is, I don't have enough data loaded. I wasn't expecting to do it, I'm sorry. But yeah, so that's kind of the first print. And then the original first print, if you come in here, which is also available, first print, this is the original one. And it's, you know, it's the same thing, except for you can see right here, the first print is a little bit lower. It's still that zone is what we're looking for. The other one was sitting right at the top of this versus the lower part, but it's still finding all of those key levels along the way. This one happens to show the top one too, where the other one didn't, but you're getting them both. So, these ones, it displays on the original one. I'm going to talk with Gianluca before we get it out. On the original one, right as soon as it passes a line, a level, like as it comes up into this level, it displays all of the calculations are done, but it displays it as it closes through the first one. So you'd get the next one as it closes through. That's kind of why you see the stair stepping. The other one should do the same thing, and it doesn't look like it does right now, but I'll get that fixed before tomorrow. So, yeah. Of course. Are the lines set at open? Yes. It's the very first tick. I mean, if you were here at 3 o'clock in the morning, your levels are set. It's not something that you have to wait until 9 or anything like that. They're set right off the bat. So that looks like all the questions. So unless you guys have any other questions, that's going to do it. I hope you found, I'm super excited about it. I think that I kind of made that clear, but I want you guys to be excited about it too. And if you have any questions, anyone who's been with this company for any amount of time, you know that I'm extremely transparent and forthcoming with everything. Sometimes it's detrimental, but I am more than willing to answer any questions you have. My email address is rolson@nervsys.com. Feel free to email me if you have any pre-purchase questions or post-purchase questions. And I'll be happy to answer that. Richard, once you get to the Discord and you sign in, do the disclaimer, send Nirvana Ryan a message and I'll get you access to it. And it starts at 7:07 Central. And we go until 9. Thank you, Craig. No, I see, it's like So I struggled with this today because, like, as I was coming up with the presentation, I'm in my mind actually on on my PowerPoints, I'm going through and I'm doing this history and all this stuff. I'm so excited about it. I'm adding all this stuff. And then I'm like, well, this is supposed to be a marketing thing, not a Ryan super excited about this thing. So I had to go back and redo it to kind of hit the high points of things along the way. I am super excited about it. I mean, you know, there's a difference between like a company building something that really works and an individual who comes up with an idea that the company sees the value in and then puts it out there as well. So it's, you know, this was a passion of love for me since 2012. And the fact that Jeff called me up and was like, you know, we're ready. Do you have something? And I actually had it ready. So I was super, super excited to have that. What is Discord? Discord is an online community that you can chat. We have live sessions in here. It's like a forum, a living, breathing forum that's in real time. The link is up in the chat a little bit further. If you missed it, just scroll up a little bit. You can sign up there. It's free. You can do it in a browser. Fellow investor, you were late. This is the presentation recorded? Yes, actually, it's streaming live on YouTube right now. So you can go to nirvanasystems.com. I'm sorry, not Nirvana Systems. Go to youtube.com/Nirvana Systems. It's recorded there, but I have recorded this as well, and I will get it out to you guys in an email tomorrow. So it will be out tomorrow. David says, do you need VT12 to run Rhino? No. Rhino 2 works on OmniTrader 2021, and here in a couple of days it will work on Visual Trader 12. The original Rhino works on Visual Trader 11, 12, OmniTrader 19, 20, and 21. So no, you don't need it. If you don't have the current version of OmniTrader, if you're on OmniTrader 2020, it will require the update, which well, you just talk to Scott or Nathan, and we'll get that taken care of for you. All right. Well, I am going to go ahead and call it here. Again, if you want to use that discount code, it is Rhino. It works either Nirvana Club discount or 25% off discount. So it's one or the other, but a great value either way. Again, from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say, you know, I appreciate you guys coming in, and so many of you came in and you're still here. So I hope you're as excited about this as I am. This is going to be released tomorrow. The education is going to start on Tuesday. So you have a little bit of time, but the discount code ends tomorrow. So if you're looking to get in at the special pricing, that does have a hard cutoff. I didn't even cover the scans. The scans, I'm in a real time, but so we have a couple of different things. So the real time scans are run through a service called Market Scans. They are not in there yet. That is something that our data developer Constantine needs to add in there. There is, and Jason is here with me. He can maybe message me, but I think we have a real-time sign-up as well. If you don't have real-time and want to use the Rhino in real-time on your dashboard, under one of the steps, I think you're going to have an opportunity to sign up for real-time. So if you do sign up for real-time or want real-time scans when they're available, it will require that subscription to Market Scans. But yeah. Don't be sorry. I should have pulled it up. The scans are just a secondary thing. I put them in there. So we have the Rhino bands for the bulls, and then Rhino bands for the bears. Basically, it's using again the summary, the trigger, which is the crossing of the zero of the Rhino bands. We're using some trend, some volume, and some price values there. So you'll have two different scans in there for those. And they're really, really good scans. They just weren't the focal point of this. So I'm glad that you asked, but there's two scans in there for your end of day. And then, yeah. All right. Well, I hope you guys have a fantastic and restful rest of your Sunday afternoon. And if you do join us with the scans are when the scans are available on OmniScan. If you want to ask that question again, when I'll answer it. But you get the Omni scans with Omni data, or if you have our data, they'll be there. And yeah, so those will be there. Julius, thank you. But yeah, so if there's anything that wasn't answered, if you want to message me privately, again, it's rolson@nervesys.com, and look forward to seeing all of you in the training on Tuesday, or if you guys come in on Discord tomorrow, feel free to say hi. I'll answer you, and you know, we can talk in there openly and freely. So hope you guys have a great weekend, the rest of it, and thank you so much, and we will see you guys soon.